Just summarizing the session here, right from the Professor Amresh, who gave a very nice description of design innovation network, building blocks, and gave a lot of idea that how the dignity with the design can be associated. So this was one of the key features. Then there was a very good talk by the Professor Roy, where he mentioned the different aspects of community-based participation in the manufacturing and how the innovatively available materials can be used. And then as quality is the hallmark of this product and how to build it with the help of all kind of non-destructive, destructive testing tools, and it should be ingredient with the design and manufacturing both, was given by Professor Baldev Raj. And thereafter, the framework was discussed, and Professor Ravi gave a very novel idea that how the new way of involving the students, looking at the societal problems, threatening the existing system by looking into what is the end product, means how we can address the problem of the people and then accordingly frame our system to cover the teaching learning exercises, particularly in the labs. And Professor PVM Rao has given a very good example that how leadership, students, there can be new model to teaching to the students and innovatively involve them by better mentorship and looking into account the current scenarios. In this different context, what I noticed that some of the points which are posed by our honorable guest as well as our speakers, there are something also in small segments we are taking care, like arsenic problems, where a water filter need to be built up. One of the speakers, Professor Sindhu Day, has already taken up this and led to the full-fledged product development. Professor Bhadauria, not only on Moody machine, he has worked on many other machines also, which are very nicely being further improved for the helping to the people and villages. And coming to other this point, we also would like to highlight that knowledge creation and absorbing knowledge not from one source, from many source. And here we have given only 4 slides to each speaker. So there was some restrictions on that, but it has good advantage also. Because right from the beginning, if something is said in a very succinct manner, then we have to apply more stress on the man, chit and buddhi to understand very clearly that what is being said actually. So whenever there is succinct things, we have to very concentrated things are required. So based on that, we also propose, last time under the leadership of Professor Baldev Raj, when distributed manufacturing workshop was conducted, then we published a special issue of International Production Research with 22 papers, 39 authors, 39 countries and around 69 authors. For this forum also, we have already discussed with the Editor-in-Chief of Intelligent Manufacturing to come out up with special volumes on inclusive manufacturing. So all the academy experts, people, industry experts, if they feel they have to communicate something, then I think after the end of this forum, there will be announcement on that side also, that we can also communicate this thing so that this can be captured and produced in a form of journal articles, and whole themes can be represented in that manner. Now we have question and answers with respect to different aspects of this forum. So this can be actually short questions or something clarifications or some suggestions from this one, but only for 10 minutes only. So please come and ask the question.
So I'm a student from IIT Delhi. I have one question regarding community manufacturing for meeting global market demands. See, for a particular market, if you are decentralizing production, then there is a question of product consistency. So how about 2 points? One is the product consistency to meet the high quality market demand, and the second is the high cost because of decentralized manufacturing as compared to the local as compared to the current state high scale manufacturing at one level. So I wanted to know these 2 points.
First of all, very good question. Number one, about quality. And this is where I believe we need to have standards which will help in promoting quality. I think that's number one. Number two, we can design consistently and actually make designs available as open source, which can then be used by manufacturers around the world. So that's also one possibility. In fact, public-funded product development could be given open source, and then commercial world can build on that to develop further products. Okay. Now, coming back to your second point, that whether this way of community manufacturing going to increase cost, I think it is possible in some cases that cost will be more. But what is important is identify products which are suitable for community manufacture and it is not more expensive. And I will tell you why. Because if the design is open source, different communities can build products for their local consumptions, and then logistics cost is going to reduce significantly. If you look at cost of a product like this bottle of water, logistics and sales and marketing actually is a significant part of this product cost. That could be reduced if it's locally consumed. And then if the production is more than local consumption, there should be a simpler way to sell. And that's where I think in the future, if we could use, for example, cooperative, which helps purely in logistics, rural logistics, using local post offices to sell your products in a digital space, that kind of way you can sell the extra surplus. So my view is we have to be selective on projects we take for local community, and it should only be used when it's financially viable too.
Sure. Thank you.
Do you want to join in? I think this one is fixed.
Oh. Hello, yeah, okay. The question that you've asked is certainly valid, but it's rooted in industrial thinking. And industrial thinking has its origins in northwestern Europe 250 years ago, and this is India today. And as we've seen from the presentations, you've got very sophisticated technologies and very sophisticated traditions. Now, I'll give you two examples. You said about quality. Now, the framing that you're using is that quality is conformance to specification, and that specification is fixed during industrial design and engineering and manufacturing engineering. But if you think about Italy, Italy has exports from clusters that are community-based that have been going for several hundred years. Their global exports are increasing, and they're very profitable, and they support whole communities, as they have done for hundreds of years. And they're using the latest technologies related to hand skills, and it is expected that each product will be slightly unique because it's been made by a different person on a different day. So it's very profitable, it's very sustainable, and the notion of quality is not framed in these industrial terms. And also another aspect of the industrial thinking is that quality is fixed, that the specification is fixed, it's fixed from the top, and the specification is fixed for years. And the idea is to repeat that specification until a new product is subsequently introduced, maybe after 18 months or 5 years or whatever. So this means that quality, the specification is frozen. But if you have open source, the specification is never frozen. It is continually evolving. So we know this from software, for example, that the Linux system, which originated in Finland, it's not fixed from the top down, it's continually evolving. So when we think about, we've heard the word leapfrog a few times today. So when we think about leapfrog, what is it we're leapfrogging? What we need to leapfrog is centralized industrialization. Thank you.
I may add a line. We can discuss during lunch and all that. Today it is possible to ruggedize a process so that the quality is inbuilt into a product. Also, if the design is done in a good way, you can bring down the cost of the quality very, very significantly. So it needs a different structuring of the whole product. And there are n number of examples where the affordable product is as good in the performance as a high quality product. N number of examples one can pick up and give it. But the quality is thought of at the design, at the process, at the material, at the damage, at various levels.
I think I just wanted to pick up on the previous discussion. At least to my mind, I think we're talking about, or at least as I see it, we're actually talking about two different kinds of issues here. One is inclusivity in terms of coming up with products and solutions that are available to consumers or users with who may often be ignored by the markets or who have less purchasing power. And the second one is having a greater number of individuals involved in the manufacturing process. That is, you know, this same point about decentralization manufacturing. At least to my mind, these are two rather different sets of processes with very different requirements. One is talking about innovating in a particular way. The second one, in that scenario, I think has requirements for a certain level of sophistication for individuals involved in the manufacturing processes that has huge implications for education and all of that, mass education, because as soon as you start talking about customization and flexibility, you're talking about actually much more greater knowledge intensivity at the grassroots level. So I think just at least for the conversations as we go forward, I think it might be useful to take a look at these two different kinds of framings and understand that those two things, while they both have the word inclusivity in them, may have very, very different requirements, are talking about very, very different kinds of models of innovation and production and all of that. I'm not saying those can't be done and can't be reconciled, but just to, at least to my mind, put out that those really are two significantly different kinds of processes and issues to think about.
With permission from the organizing committee, we close this session, and next session is, there are posters actually outside, so and group photograph and posters, so we have to go and participate into that. Thank you.
One announcement, all speakers, participants, students, all should join the photography. It is inclusive photography. Thank you.